Hello students, I welcome you all to this video. So in the previous video, we discussed about the lesson, the best Christmas present in the, well, first two parts already finished, okay. In the first part, the narrator found a letter from his roll top desk. In the second part, author opened the letter and read out whatever has written by Jim MacPherson was read out by the narrator. In the third part, he wanted to give the letter to the concerned person. Now, in this video, we are going to study the third part. How the person, the narrator, goes to give the letter to the concerned person, Coney MacPherson. So, now he folded the letter again and he slipped the letter into the envelope. Very carefully he slipped into the letter in the envelope. Because he knew what he had to in the next morning. Okay. Once he wake up in the next morning, he has to go to the concerned person. So that night he was unable to sleep because he knew his duty. Okay. Tomorrow morning what he has to do, he knew. So he was unable to sleep on that particular day. So next morning, he woke up and he started to travel. Okay. He started to travel to Bridport. Bridport is a place just a few kilometers away from where the narrator lives. So he drove to Bridport. He has to drive Bridport. Bridport just a few kilometers away from where the narrator lives. So on his way, when he reached that place, he found a boy who was walking along with his dog, and he asked the boy where was this address. Okay, who the author asked that boy where about the address 12 Copper Beaches, Bridport, Dorset. This was the address written on the envelope. So on his way to this address, he met a boy. The boy was walking along with his dog and he asked about the address. The boy pointed a house to this author. Now the author goes there. He saw only destroyed, the house which was destroyed by fire. Okay. So the author went to see that house, but it turned out to be nothing. The house turned out to be nothing, but it was burned out cell. It was burned out empty cell because the house was destroyed by fire completely. Okay. So the narrator wants to see Mrs. Jim MacPherson. So he came to that address, but when he reached there, he found that the house was totally destroyed by fire. The house turned out to be nothing but burned out cell. So the narrator wanted to know what happened to Mrs. Jim MacPherson, because Mrs. Jim MacPherson was living in that house only. So he wanted to know what happened to Mrs. Jim MacPherson, how this tragic incident happened, okay, to that house. Okay, because the house was destroyed by fire, burned out, destroyed by fire. So he wanted to know what happened to that house, and also what about the lady, Mrs. Jim MacPherson. So he moved on to the next house and he knocked the door. A man came out and he inquired, the narrator inquired, how about the lady, Mrs. Jim MacPherson? The man said, man started to describe the lady, Mrs. Jim MacPherson, what kind of lady she was. And he said, she was a lovely lady, she was so kind, but a bit of muddle-headed. Okay, the next neighbor would say, she was a lovely lady and very kind, but bit of muddle header. What is the meaning muddle header? Muddle header means confused. Because her age was 101 years old. So Mrs. MacPherson's age was 101 years old. So in that age, 101 years old, in that age, if she was entitled to be, it happens to anyone, okay? Muddle headed, which means confused. Okay? Muddle headed means confused. Mrs. MacPherson, 101 years old, at this age, she was entitled to be muddle headed, confused. The man described, the neighborhood described how Mrs. MacPherson was. Okay? How Mrs. MacPherson was, the neighborhood described, and also how could be that tragic incident would have happened. That also narrated by neighborhood. What kind of lady she was? She only used candles for light. Okay? In night time, she used only candles. She would never use electricity. Okay? Because she felt electricity could be more expensive. So that is what her idea. So she would use only candles for light. So that might be the reason why the house got fire and it was totally destroyed. Okay? It turned out to be nothing but it burned out cell. Okay? The house was totally destroyed by fire because Mrs. MacPherson, Connie MacPherson, would use candles instead of electricity. Why? Because she believed that electricity could be more expensive than candles. That's why she might have used candles instead of electricity. That might be the reason why the whole house burned out and now destroyed by fire. But fortunately, firemen reached out in time and they saved Mrs. MacPherson safely. Okay? They saved her well. But the house was totally damaged, but they were able to escape Mrs. MacPherson from the fire. So now, further we explain, the neighborhood explains what happened next to the Mrs. MacPherson. So after he was taken from that house, she was rushed to the hospital. Okay? She was taken to the hospital. She was rushed to the hospital. Where? In which hospital she was taken? Burlington House Nursing Home. Okay? She was taken. She was rushed to Burlington House Nursing Home. Where is? On the Gloucester Road, on the other side of the town. On the Gloucester Road, other side of the town. Burlington House Nursing Home. Okay? So now the narrator needs to go to the hospital. Now she has been, Mrs. MacPherson has been hospitalized in Burlington House Nursing Home. So now the narrator needs to go there and he goes there. It was the Christmas day. That is the one special thing we have to mind. Okay? It was a Christmas day. The whole hospital was decorated. How it was decorated? See, paper chains are in the hallway and lighted Christmas tree. Okay? Lighted Christmas tree stood in the corner. Christmas tree stood in the corner with a lopsided angel on the tree and also lopsided angel. Lopsided means bent on one side. Bent on one side. Okay? Lopsided angel on top. So, the hospital also decorated because on the day people are celebrating Christmas. On the Christmas day, he wanted to give the letter to Mrs. MacPherson. So when he entered into the hospital, so all of them were wearing a paper hat and also they were singing because they were celebrating Christmas. And he was seeing through the window, some people were sitting. He was looking for Mrs. MacPherson. By this time, a matron came to there. So the narrator entered The narrator entered into the hospital. There was a matron. Matron means head nurse. Okay. There was a head nurse, and he told about the visit. Okay. Because of this reason, I have a letter which needs to be given to Mrs. Jim MacPherson. That's why I have visited this hospital. After hearing this, the matron was surprised because no one has visited till now because she has no relation at all. Okay. If she looked you, if she sees you, that really she would be satisfied, she would be pleased, she must be pleased to see you. Okay, so she takes him to the room where Jim MacPherson was living. Mrs. Jim MacPherson was living. So when he was asking about why she was kept alone, head nurse told him that normally mother cadet, she was mother cadet, but on that particular day she was little more confused. Okay, Mrs. Jim MacPherson was little more confused. So she desperately needed some rest. That's why we thought we had a plan to keep her alone, to give some rest. Okay, when the narrator entered into the room, she was gazing out to the window. She was looking out the window and her hands. So she was gazing out at the door. Jim MacPherson was gazing out at the door, looked out at the door. When I entered into the room, I said hello. She turned around and looked up at me. Then I said happy Christmas. Then I showed that thing was, I found this and it must be yours. I think it is yours. When I am speaking, her eyes never left. Okay? When I am speaking to her, eyes never left. When I am speaking to her, eyes never left. Her eyes never left. And I removed the thin box and I took the letter. That was the moment her eyes lit up with recognition. But also her face became suffused with sudden glow of happiness. Okay, she was so happy to see that. Then I told everything, how I got the letter, from where I got that desk. Then everything I explained to Mrs. Jim MacPherson. But she did not listen anything. Okay, she did not listen anything. Just looking. After that, after a few minutes of silence, she hold my hand and also her eyes were filled with tears. You told me that you would be home by Christmas. You told me you would be home by Christmas and now you have come. Okay, now you have come on Christmas Day. This is the best Christmas ever I have. Who told this? Mrs. Jim MacPherson told, this is the best Christmas ever I had because you told me you would be coming here by Christmas Day. Today is Christmas Day and you are here, so I never forget this day. This could be my best Christmas. Who said? Mrs. Jim MacPherson. And then she said, I read your letter every day. Okay? I read your letter every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my mind. Okay? I wanted to hear your voice in my mind so that I feel that you are always with me. Okay? So that you are always with me. Now you read it. I want to hear your voice. Okay? Now she asked the narrator, now you read me this for me. You read this for me. I wanted to hear your voice. Would you do that for me? She asked. Okay, she asked the narrator. Okay, now you read it. Then we will have a tea. I have prepared you cake, marzipan cake that you would ever love to have. That marzipan cake I have prepared. You may have. So this is how the story ends. Actually, she took up the narrator that he is Jim MacPherson. He is not that Jim MacPherson, but he is the narrator the one who found the letter from the roll top desk. The roll top desk was bought from the junk shop. Okay. So, but us sees a confused lady, muddle-headed lady. She thought, see, he is Jim MacPherson. Okay, he is Jim MacPherson. So you may understand this now. So now the Mrs. MacPherson's age is 101 year old. Okay, when after the letter, he was writing a letter few years before. He got a letter, but the person, he never come back. Okay, he never came back. Mr. Jim MacPherson never came back to Bridport. Only the letter was received by Mrs. Jim MacPherson. So he kept the letter in the roll top desk. And she had been waiting him for long years, but he never returned. One day, because of the fire accident, she was hospitalized, and the roll top desk was sold to the junk shop. So the roll top desk was bought by narrator. So he wanted to give the letter to the concerned person after reading the whole story, whichever stated in the letter. So after reading that, he had a feeling this letter must be reached to who has to have this letter. Who is supposed to have this letter must have this letter. That is what his idea. So in the first part, the narrator bought a roll top desk from junk shop. When he was trying to mend the roll top desk, he found a letter and he wanted to read out the letter. And that part, after reading that, he wanted to give the letter to the concerned person. Okay. So when he was giving the letter to Mrs. Jim MacPherson, she was taking her as his husband, Mr. Jim MacPherson. Okay. So that's why he says that this is the best Christmas ever I had, because you said that you would come here on Christmas Day. Today is Christmas Day and you are here. I am so happy. I wanted to hear your voice in my mind so that I feel that you are always with me. Now you read that letter. If you read, I will be very happy. After that, we will have tea and I have prepared you Christmas cake for Christmas cake. Okay? That is how the story ends. So this story has three parts. All three parts have been discussed in this class. In the next video, I will be giving line-by-line explanations. Just you go through this lesson twice or thrice, you will be understanding the lesson very well. It's a simple lesson, simple story. It has three parts. First part, he found a letter. Second part, he was reading out the letter. Third part, he goes to the concerned person to give the lesson. Okay? Thank you very much.